Welcome to this March 2023 update for Power BI Paginated Reports. Since the last recording, there have been a number of exciting announcements and new features, and I'm happy to present them to you here in this video. So there are four topics to present, starting with support for all Power BI licenses, a new migration tool, web authoring, and report drill through. So formerly, paginated reports were a premium feature. Either the workspace needed to be on a dedicated capacity with premium license, or you needed a premium per user license. Well, the news is that paginated reports are now available with all licenses. Note that users with a free license can only publish paginated reports to their personal workspace. Note also that the use of the export to file API, this is in programmatic work, to export paginated reports remains a premium only feature. Next, a migration tool. Built into SQL Server reporting services in 2017, 2019, and 2022, there is a migration tool that can help you to automate reports direct to Power BI. Consider offloading reporting services workloads to Power BI. That way you can allow SQL Server to focus on core business operations. Let's take a look at how the migration tool works. So here I am in Power BI Report Server, and it's simply a matter of going to the publish command and publishing all reports, or in this case, publishing a selection of reports. Having selected several reports, I then click on Publish to Power BI. The next step then is to determine the target workspace. And if you're working with information protection, you might also apply sensitivity labels. Then go ahead and click Publish, and the migration happens automatically. And here we can see that three reports were successfully published. I then have the option of opening up the Power BI service, allowing me to verify that the migration has indeed succeeded. Web authoring. You can now easily create paginated reports based on Power BI datasets by working in the Power BI service. Specifically, you can add filters and a table and styling and totals. At this stage, the experience is pretty simple, but expect to see incremental paginated report web authoring features coming soon. Now consider this, you can download the RDL file and open it in Report Builder. And then in Report Builder, you can enhance the report design. So for some web authors, this could be the perfect starting point. Use the service to create a basic report and then refine the design in Report Builder. Let's see how it works in demonstration. Here in the Power BI service, I have the sales and marketing workspace. Inside this workspace, I have a dataset and a Power BI report. Let me go ahead and select the sales analysis dataset. And here on the dataset landing page, I can use the Create a Report option to create a paginated report. This is the web authoring experience. Let me start the design of this report by dragging the fiscal year field into the filters. I'll then expand fiscal year and I'll filter by fiscal year 2021. To create a formatted table, I will then drag the month field and drop it onto the report canvas. And here I can see all of the months of fiscal year 2021. Next, from the sales table, I will drag the sales and drop it into the table. And then from the target table, I will drop the target field into the report. I have some basic formatting abilities. For example, I can change the width of columns. And now let me introduce variance and variance percent. I have the option also with table format to turn off the totals or put them back again. And lastly, I can move the table around on the page. Switching to the view menu, I have the ability to look at the report as a web layout in web format or switch back to a print layout. Then on the file menu, I have the ability to save, print, or download. Let me go ahead and save, and I'll save this as the sales performance report. And now let me download the report as well. And now that I've downloaded the RDL document, I'll go ahead and open it in Report Builder. and this is just a standard RDL document allowing me to work beyond the web authoring capabilities, for example, like formatting the header. I can then save, publish back to the workspace. Report drill through. Drill through allows navigation between paginated reports. It's set up by configuring an action on a text box or other elements in the report design. While this capability has been supported in reporting services reports since the very beginning of the product, it's now available in paginated reports for Power BI. However, there are some limitations to be aware of. Firstly, you must enter the report directly. There's no ability to browse for the report. And secondly, you must add and set up the target report parameters yourself. Report Builder doesn't give you assistance in setting that up. Let's see how it works in demonstration. In this workspace, there are two paginated reports, the Sales Orders Report and the Sales Performance Report. Let's start by taking a look at the Sales Orders Report. It has two parameters, requiring the entry of a fiscal year and the selection of one or more employees. I'll go ahead and select the first. And here we can see a list of all sales orders for Pamela the salesperson. Let's now take a closer look at the report design. I'll go ahead and download the report and then open it in Report Builder. Notice then, in the report data pane, that there are two parameters, date fiscal year and salesperson employee ID. I then close this report, and let's take a look at the second paginated report, sales performance. Here we can see a table visual, and when I drill into the United States group, I can see the individual salespeople. But what I'd really like to see is the ability to click on a salesperson and then drill through to those order details. Well, now that's possible. So I go ahead and I download and open up the report in Report Builder. I then select the text box for the salesperson and I go ahead and open its properties. Then, on the action page, I select the option to go to Report. Now, to specify a report, I must type the report name in. And because I know that the report has two parameters, I click the Add button twice, and then I must enter the names of those parameters. Next, I must set the value. So for date fiscal year, I use the parameter of this report that is the value of the date fiscal year. For the salesperson employee ID, in the data set, I have an employee ID field, and so its value will be passed to that parameter. Now, before I click OK and complete that setup, I want to provide an obvious clue to report consumers that there's a link enabling this drill through. So I select the font page, and I modify the color from black to blue, and I set the effects to underline, so it appears to be like a hyperlink. Now I click OK. On the home ribbon, I publish. And I overwrite the current definition of that sales performance report. I then close Report Builder. Back here in the Power BI service, I go ahead and press F5 to reload the page. Now, when I drill through from a country and select Michael Blythe, here is the drill through showing me the details for Michael Blythe. Finally, some resources that you might find helpful related to the topics presented in this video. Thanks for watching.